Hi, this is Peter Stanley. Welcome to my channel. Today I want to take a look at the new light from Growstar. It's the MN-W3000 LED grow light. And it's one of the newer light bar array type lights. I'm going to open up here in just a second, but I just want to give you an overview. The power draw is 220 watts. It's got a Meanwell driver, LM301B diodes. They're the 5000K, 3000K, and 740 nanometer infrared and 660 nanometer red, and it's dimmable, and it can be daisy chained, and it also is foldable to 180 degrees. So yeah, let's go ahead and open this up. I've already cut the tape on this, so pretty cool. This comes with a timer. We've got the rope hangers, daisy chain cable, power cord. Looks like it can be detached also. Don't know what this is, this little screw is for, but got that. Here's user manual. Okay. So we've got the this is folded up, of course, but it's got the XLG240HAB Meanwell driver. It has a control box. Let me get this off. Control box, variable dimming. These are for the daisy chaining and on and off switch. K1, K2. This is K1. There's also a switch for K2, and I don't know what that means. Could be that it switches on either side. I don't really know yet. And also it could be, you know, standalone or daisy chained. Have no idea. So I'll have to plug it up and play with it. So anyway, see what that screws for. Still hold this together. Put this in real quick. That's how that looks fully opened up. It's fairly large LED bars look like. So you could angle it down sort of like that if you wanted to kind of hit the tops and the sides a little bit. So the length on this, or the long way if it's fully straight, it's exactly 24 and a half inches long, and it is exactly 22 inches wide. So this wouldn't fit necessarily in a 2x2 tent. I mean, the edges would be right up against the tent. I guess you could. I mean, I wouldn't want it that close to the tent walls, but so it'd probably be a better fit for something a little bigger than that, like a 2.5x2.5 or a 3x3 tent. So what I'm going to do is hook this up in the tent to test everything, and I'll leave it plugged in for 30 minutes, turned all the way up. I'll do a power reading, and I'll do some temperature readings on the driver and the components here, and then I'll do an efficiency test, and I'm using the Apogee MQ500 quantum sensor by Apogee Instruments to do my efficiency test and power readings. So yeah, so let's go ahead and take this downstairs to the basement and hook it up. We'll take a closer look. All right, so I got it plugged up. It's been turned on at full power for 30 minutes. Fluctuating between 219 and 220. Oh, I did find out there's a switch on the back of this box, and that enables the daisy chaining. So you would normally have it off. So you'd use this switch when it's in standalone mode. Do a couple temp readings. All right, so the driver is 109, 110. Little box reading 83. So we're getting 105, 108 on the bar there. Around 110 on the outside bar. Close to 110 on this, 110 on that bar. 106. This little piece here is on 95. So that's kind of average on the other lights I've tested. For the amount of power it's pulling, it's really pretty low. That's how they look underneath. These are the numbers I got. I'll put them up on the screen, make it a little easier to see. But so when I tested at 30 minutes on, I had 219 watts. The max PPFD was 1032, and this was 10.25 inches above sensor. And this was a 30 inch measure area, which you can see down there. So on the where I took measurements, the average was 646 PPFD, usable PPF 375. The micromole per watt is 1.7, but I think that's a conservative number considering, I think in these, it's really hard to do good tests inside of a grow tent, unless the grow tent's the exact same size as your capture area. So even though there's some light reflected on the walls, if I had like reflective walls right on the boundary, I think I would have captured more light and probably gotten a higher efficiency. So take that number with a grain of salt. I'm planning to put together something kind of like what Shane at Migra has with like a dedicated table and hang my lights from the ceiling. So there's no, you know, wobbliness and fewer variables to affect the accuracy. So now I have some reflective walls in around my capture area. So I think I'll get more accurate results doing that, but it's going to take a little while to set that up. But I'm in the process of building that. But just on what I measured on the 30 inch by 30 inch and the numbers the readings I got, that's the numbers I have. Looks like a decent light. I mean, it's solid. It's got good name brand driver, good diodes. I'm like touching. I mean, that driver is pretty warm, but I mean, it's not burning me. So, I mean, it's got really good heat dissipation, really nice coverage area. So yeah, that looks like a good light. Thank you, Growstar, for sending this to me for review. So anyway, hope you found that useful. Thank you very much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe.